Today we would like to share our test setup for a three-phase CTE metering reference design, the TETA010243. There are three main parts to this test setup. First, we have the MTE, which simulates a power output for our test. Next, we have the reference design board under test. And lastly, we have the evaluation GUI on the computer. After connecting the board to the test equipment and ensuring the GUI is connected on the computer, we can begin testing by setting our output on the MTE. The MTE allows us to simulate different power topologies, such as three-phase, split-phase, and single-phase. Here, we'll be evaluating a three-phase Y configuration. For this demo, I'll be outputting 240 volts at 50 amps with a 60-degree phase angle to evaluate our reference design. Once the MTE is outputting the power, we can immediately see the board respond with active and reactive LED pulses. The pulses are fed back into the MTE for a later test. Moving over to the GUI, we can see the moment the MTE begins outputting. The corresponding areas of the GUI begin to set change and settle at the values that we're expecting. This demo will specifically show the voltage RMS, the current RMS, and the voltage to current angle, and active power. You can notice that as these values settle, they're very close to the values that we had entered on the MTE earlier. This test will see how accurate the GUI is. Moving back to the MTE, you'll recall that we're feeding the active and reactive pulses back into the test equipment for this next test. Here we can switch tabs to take a look at the accuracy of those outputted pulses. The MTE will read our pulses and give us an average percent error. This is an important test because it is often used to determine if standards are being met. Through demos like these, we can help establish standard requirements for accurate e-metering. Thanks for watching, and for more information, visit ti.com.